Hey guys, what's going on? This is Deadly. Welcome back to the Survivalist. We're going to be heading back up to our camping tent, seeing if it's still there, and hopefully, if it is, our supplies will be there as well. In my inventory, we still got the zucchini seeds. We got a PET bottle. We got a couple zucchinis, nothing too crazy. As you can see, we're not energized. A few chicken breasts. We got our bone arrows, and we also have this face mask camo pattern. I've been thinking about using this. But I can't, it doesn't really fit. So I don't know whether or not I should be using this or not. You guys should let me know in the comment section whether or not I should be using this face mask camo pattern or not. But anyways, back to our camp we go. It's gonna take a little bit because I don't really remember exactly where our camp is. So I'm gonna have to go back up and find it. I know what town it is in, but I don't travel around these northern areas that much, so I don't know it like the back of my hand, like some other places. So I just know that it's in the northwest, which is it's in the northeast, which is the direction that we're running in. But I'm also going to be looking for any camping tents or barrels that we spot along the way, if we even spot any at all. I mean, we might not. But if we get really lucky, we still need to find a barrel, which is going to be part of the goal today. Okay, so we are back in our village here. I should really learn the name of this village. Anyway, here's the moment of truth. I guarantee it's not. Oh my god, it's still here. What about our barrel? Let's go check to see if our barrel is still here. But first, let's go take a look at the campsite. Oh my god, guys, I'm excited. It's been like almost a week. I don't know if someone griefed it or not. And it looks like our harvesting patch is still here as well. Nothing. Okay, well, at least we still have the tent. You know, we still got that. I mean, that's not a surprise. What about the barrel? I'd say the barrel has been gone as well, but I don't know exactly where I ditched it. I ditched it in this pond, in this creek. It might still be here, though. Oh my god, it is. So we still have our barrel, though. So our barrel has survived. Can't believe our barrel survived. That's pretty fucking sweet. I mean, it's good to know that this place is amazing for keeping barrels, so I don't know. I don't know whether or not I should, I'm gonna move the tent, I think. Oh no, our hoe is gone. Can we prepare? Ah. Damn it. Okay. All right. We are in a bit of a problem. So whoever took our shit out of the camping tent, bravo, sir, bravo. I think we should go and search. Well, first let's eat our zucchinis, and then we should go and search the town for some supplies and try to make a game plan on what we're gonna do next. Man, these civilian camping tents though are just not great for storing supplies. I don't know if it's somebody from like a viewer who's griefing my stashes, which could be happening. So maybe I need to be a little bit better at like hiding exactly where I'm building my camps. But whoever took the stuff out of my camping tent is not smart enough to figure out where my barrel is. So this spot might still be viable, but at the same time, me saying this is going to probably get that guy all pissed off and he's going to come back looking for the barrel. So I think we're going to have to move locations, but instead of using a camping tent this time, we're going to have to hide a barrel, which is going to be a whole lot easier to hide, I can tell you that. And we are energized again, so we got time to go for a little bit of an exploration through this village, and I think we're gonna go do that right now. See if we can find another farming hoe, because the zucchinis, it seems like we're gonna have to probably make another fucking zucchini farm, or find some pumpkins, or maybe some tomatoes, or just I would like to grow some tomatoes. Maybe something different than zucchinis would be cool this time. And I also wanted to just mention that, like, whoever wrote a comment on using disinfectant spray on your plants in the pre-stage, whenever you see that there's bugs on them, that's a really good idea, but I think for the spirit of this series, I'm not going to be doing that, because I'm going to need to take seeds from plants anyway, and, you know, if there's rotten food, I'm just going to utilize it for seeds, so it's not that big of a deal. Whenever you're looking for farming tools or anything like that, these grocery stores are really good for them. So finding farming tools like axes, hoes, also seeds. These are really good for it. And especially in the back room here. I don't know if we have anything specifically, but hey, look at that. We do have some stuff. There is a walkie, but we're just going to grab that axe for now, because I think we're going to have to make our first fire of the series, which is fine. And we can show you guys the whole fire thing. And I can talk to you guys on why I think the butane stove method is just such a more superior way of cooking food. There's a Winchester Model 70 right there. That's pretty sweet. Okay, guys. So I guess we're going to be doing a lesson in how to make a fire without any matches and only using an axe or a knife. If you have a knife and you want to make a fireplace, you're going to have to make a fire using only sticks. But if you have an axe, then you can make a fire using logs. You don't need matches because you can make a hand drill, which is a improvised way of starting a fire. So I'm going to be showing you guys that for anybody who's never done it before. But I'm sure a lot of people have. So step one, we're going to want to make our way of starting our fire, which is going to be collecting the bark. Now, there's two different types of bark in DayZ. There's birch bark and regular tree bark. So if you don't know the difference between a birch tree and a regular tree, basically birch is like white trunks and regular trees are dark trunks. So this is the proper bark that you want. And this is going to make our fireboard. And then you're going to want to get some sticks. So just like in last video, I showed you guys a good way of getting branches and like three sticks. So we're going to do the exact same method here. We're going to make the sharpened stick, and then we're going to cut that sharpened stick into thirds. We're going to use the sticks on the bark to make a hand drill kit. Now, one criticism I had back in 0.59 is whenever you really make a hand drill in real life or a bow drill, you could get multiple uses out of it. And back in the day, back in the last patch, you used the bow drill once and, that was it. Now you can actually use it more often, and that's great. So we'll definitely be holding on to this bow drill for a little bit as well. So next, you're going to want to get something to start the fire. So you can either use a rag, but you don't need to use a rag at all, or a piece of paper. You can just use another piece of bark. So let's get another piece. All right, awesome. So we have that going. We pretty much have everything that we need now other than the logs to start our fire. So let's kind of get this going here. This will be a nice little spot. So let's do... create the fireplace, and let's set this fireplace kit somewhere where I would love to place it, maybe like right here, but I doubt it's gonna let me light a fire here. We'll just leave it there for now, and let's go cut down a tree. Well, this one looks okay. All right, cool. So you also get a stick whenever you cut down a tree, which we're gonna need later, just a heads up. And stack the logs that you get from cutting the tree into three. It makes it easier. And then you want to drag your logs onto your fire. Add it as an attachment. Don't put it in here. If you put it in here, it's not going to do anything. It's going to ruin the logs. You want to add it as an attachment. Once everything's in place, you ignite by a hand drill. And it is going to work, which is great. Doesn't really have the proper animation yet, and it is a little bit, I will say, it is a little bit too fast for a hand drill. I think you should really be, your character should be going at it, trying to get this fire started for at least a minute, and maybe have a random chance. They could even make it a soft skill down the road, that the more you use the hand drill kit, the more likely of a chance that you'll actually get a fire started with it. So there's a lot of different things, and also bow drills too. There's a lot of different unexplored things that they have not done yet when it comes to the improvised way of starting a fire. So in order for us to cook our chicken, we're going to do it in my opinion, one of the worst ways possible, just because it takes so long. But we're going to put their chicken onto this long wooden stick and pose it towards the fire. And you can only do one chicken at a time. There's a lot of room on there for that chicken. I think you should be able to add four pieces of chicken on the end of that stick. What about you guys? I don't know. We'll see. And then you just wait patiently. It's another, you'll see it warming up on the end of the stick. This method does cook chicken reasonably fast. It's just, it doesn't cook it nearly as quickly as the butane. And the butane doesn't give off all this light and smoke attracting people to the location. So once this chicken breast gets cooked, you'll visually see it again, just like the other chicken, but it will look slightly different. So don't be put off by that. If you've boiled chicken and you think that the chicken doesn't look good because it's got like a different image on it, see, look how that looks different from the other chicken that we've had. That's okay. This is definitely still good. In fact, it almost looks better whenever you cook it on the fire. So this chicken breast is good to go. So we're just going to repeat this process a few more times. And then we should have 4 pieces of chicken, which will keep us alive. Hopefully for the duration that we move our barrel. If I was going to put some bets, I'm going to say this is going to take 1.5 minutes. But it might be sooner than that. It might be some just random generated number. And it looks like it is. It's about a 1 minute and 15 seconds per piece of chicken to cook. So if you're going to be cooking 4 pieces of chicken, you're going to have 5 minutes of downtime. Opposed to when you use the butane method, you're going to have only 1 minute of downtime, or about 1 minute and 15 seconds of downtime. People must have been looking for the barrel all over the place, but they never thought to look in here. So there's the barrel right there. I just chucked it and it landed like that. And it doesn't change positions on login. It stays like that. So the reason why I know this location was because I found a barrel chucked deep into the water right there. But it's time for us to move, man. We gotta do some risky shit. Now is the time. There's also something else I would want to do, and that's with rabbit snares. I've heard that rabbit snares are actually functioning very similar to that of H1Z1 right now, where if you put a rabbit snare down, then a rabbit will actually physically spawn in the world, and there's like a 50% chance that it will actually hit the snare. And if it does, you can skin the rabbit, and you can get 2 pieces of leather, actually, out of every rabbit skin that you tan. In my opinion, that's a little unrealistic. However, it will be a good way for us to start collecting leather that doesn't rely necessarily on hunting animals. But that's, again, for something that's going to have to happen way down the run, down the road. Won't be able to happen now, because like I said before, this barrel will not be able to tan anything. This barrel is going to be specifically for keeping supplies, and that's it. Oh, shit. Hey, speak of that. Oh, right. This kind of sucks for the deer, but it's great for us. Oh god, maybe not. Get the barrel, get the fuck out of here. Someone killed that deer. Someone has killed the deer. I don't know how long ago that's been. Oh man, that's the first sign of human contact right there, guys. We could use the pelts. And we could also use the meat, but I think right now is we just gotta stay alive. That is scary. This is the most afraid I think I felt on this character for quite some time. That confirms that there are people up here. Oh shit, guys, we just found a barrel. We just found a barrel right in front of us. This is a fucking big deal. This is a really big deal. This is a massive deal. It has holes poked in it as well. This game is taunting me. I swear this game is taunting me. I'm gonna keep my eyes open too. You never know. We might see a barrel poking out of a tree somewhere around here. Ah, we have a camping tent actually. Okay. Well, we'll take a look at the camping tent. Make sure. We have a barrel. Okay, we have a camping tent and we have a barrel. Okay. Does this... Hopefully no one's around. Hopefully no one is around. Okay, this is real, guys. This is serious. Please, don't have holes poked in it. Please, don't... Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. It has holes poked in it, of course. And of course the color is blue. Why? Why do all the barrels have holes in them? I mean, the only thing I could probably take from this is a splint. There's another barrel. Oh, there's another barrel. It has holes in it too! What the fuck, man? I feel like someone's just going around poking holes in everybody's barrel. I feel like that's what some dick's doing. I've never seen so many barrels with holes poked in them in my life, not even on DayZ Underground. I don't get it, man. Some dude is totally like Dennis the Menace when it comes to fucking barrels. I'm telling you, dude. There's a guy who's making it his mission. And his mission is to poke as many holes as he can in everyone's barrels so that nobody can tan leather. The good news is we're actually finding camps and barrels. The bad news is it's just not the right ones. I mean, it's very thick forest. We don't necessarily need to place... Oh. Okay, we got yet another... We got another little camping tent here. It's got a note in it. We're sorry we compromised your tent. I hope you don't mind. Just two lone wanderers looking for some trouble to get in. If you get this message in time, please meet us at the house up the road from your tent. We have food, water, and weapons. Just trying to help. Good day to you all and safe travels. Sincerely, Chelsea and Sam. I didn't think you could actually still write notes. I thought people were told me that notes weren't really working. That's interesting. So, okay. Well, I've successfully stored our barrel for now, but we're at the point where there's nothing I need to really store in there. Unfortunately, for the sake of this series, I won't be showcasing where my barrel is, but it is a little, it's nice and hidden, and it's very far out of the way, so I'm only going to store the most valuable items in there. I have a strong suspicion that no one is going to find it. So we have a vehicle here. Hello, anybody home? This looks like Chelsea and Sam's estate. Yeah. So we got somebody with a fully functioning off-road. I don't think this spawns in here like this, but I could be wrong. I spent some time looking through Chelsea and Sam's area, but I never really found any tents or barrels stashed. But I think that's about it for this episode, guys. If you liked what you see, then make sure you let me know in the comment section below. Share this video series around with your friends if you think people might enjoy it. And definitely watch my live streams every single morning at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Twitch. The next episode, we will be establishing yet another base, doing more horticulture, doing some more hunting for chickens, and just getting established and getting a new base set up, a new permanent base that I think is going to be our final location in the series. So I can't wait. I think it's a really good spot, and I'm pretty excited for the next episode, guys. So stick around, and thanks again for watching.